Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to my San Francisco 49ers franchise mode series here in Madden 17 on the Xbox One. Now, we've completed our offseason work, both free agency and the NFL draft. You can see those episodes by clicking on the little information tab and the links in the top right corner of the video. But we are moving on to our second season here with head coach Quarter Pounder and the San Francisco 49ers. We've retooled this lineup a little bit. We got out from under some very weighty contracts, in some cases for players that weren't even hitting the field very much. And we definitely got younger overall in this roster. And speaking of younger, we'll be starting a rookie quarterback week one here. The debut of number 14, Carson Helfitt, out of UCLA, second round draft pick. We were able to take him after deliberating taking him with the fifth pick overall. We're able to get him in the second round, which we feel is a steal since we got both of our targets, including that stud left outside linebacker DeAndre Groves out of Michigan State. We'll see him in a little bit. Actually, you'll see him right now as he assists on the tackle of Adrian Peterson. So he's in that lineup in game one. And we're going to see that lineup here. What we've got going on the defensive line, the linebacking core, including rookie DeAndre Groves wearing 56, a la Lawrence Taylor there. And you've got our retooled defensive backfield as well, including Bakari Rambo, who came in free agency. All the pieces put together to hopefully make this a much better defense than last year because, well, there's nowhere to go but up on that. So it's time to see our rookie quarterback in action.
Here's the first drive now for the 49ers. And they will be led out by a young man, probably with some butterflies here. A lot of anticipation making his first NFL start.
Okay, so there's some different schools of thought on how to break in a rookie quarterback. Do you hand off the ball, let the game kind of get going through the running game, or do you let him let loose right away and try to get that confidence of completing a pass? Well, that's what we choose right there. He completes his first pass in the NFL for 8 yards. On second and two, it'll be a handoff, and that'll be Carlos Hyde getting a first down. So we move the chains. Okay. Be nice to have a successful drive to start the season off. Once again, Carlos Hyde right up the middle. And he'll get some decent yardage. 5 yards we'll give him as we look at our retooled offensive line. Again, not going to set the world on fire, but we think we made some pretty good moves. We bring in LeGarrette Blount for backup running back purposes here. The 1-2 punch, if you will. And hey, here's a newcomer as well via free agency. That's Cecil Shorts III. And he's making the catch to give us a first down at the 42-yard line. Hopefully this opening drive is giving Carson Helfitt a little bit of confidence in his abilities here. He's going to roll out on the play action. And, well, that didn't work. That is a loss of 11 yards. That could have worked out a lot better. Sharif Floyd is the one that drags him down. No chance right there as Quarter Pounder is like, ah. Okay, back to the drawing board on that. Now, trying to take advantage of them, blitzing, possibly set up that screen. We don't get a lot, but we do get some yardage. And you're going to see the recap of our draft here. We're very excited, especially about the top three and their contributions as this season goes along. Third and 17 now. Helfitt steps into this throw. And speaking of draft picks, there's Asher Combs out of Pittsburgh. We traded back up in the second round to get him, and it looks like that could be a good move on our part as he makes a big catch right there on third and long, keeping our drive going. It's going to be third and inches now. Miller, the fullback, in, leading the way for Carlos Hyde. He's got a first down, down to the 14. How about second and 10? Shotgun snap out to the flat to Carlos Hyde. He's fighting for that first down, but he's going to be well short. It's third and 4 now. Another shotgun snap. Helfitt wants to throw, and that one gets away from him. Maybe a little bit of rookie nerves right there, squeezing the football. Or maybe you can just chalk it up to rookie inconsistency. Either way, our drive's going to stall, and we're going to bring Matt Prater out for the first time in a 49ers uniform. He is taking over the kicking duties this year. That kick is up, and it is good. So we get the first score of the game, albeit not the touchdown we were really hoping for to end this long drive, but it is 3-0 now. And oh, there's your rookie, DeAndre Groves, getting a little too excited, jumping the snap. And he will be offside. It's going to be 5 yards. A freebie for the Vikings. Make it first and 5. As he is also working out those nerves. But you know what? He is not going to let that get him down. He gets in there and gets his very first NFL sack. probably the first of many with this guy's motor, as they were having a real hard time containing him on that play. It's already very apparent that this is going to bring a new dynamic to our defense this year, whether it be sacks or quarterback hurries. He is going to put a lot of pressure into other teams making mistakes at the quarterback position, and going to put a lot of pressure on offensive linemen to try to block him. Here they do block him, and it's going to work out for the Vikings as it is completed over the middle, but a huge hit, and Jarius Wright loses the football. It's picked up by the Niners. Big turnover right there, as they thought they had a big gain, but Jarius Wright gets destroyed over the middle of the field. Who was it that hit him? Let's take a look, and it's Bakari Rambo, already showing that our money in free agency thrown into the safety positions there, a very good move as he's able to make a difference and get a turnover. You got Bakari Rambo back there in the defensive backfield. You also got Brandon Boykin, who has been brought over in free agency as well, hopefully shoring up things on the defensive side along with DeAndre Groves. On the offensive side, having some problems right there as Linval Joseph gets in for the sack. It's 3rd and 17. We had one of these earlier, and we were able to convert on the pass to Asher Combs. This time he's drilled, and the throw one-on-one is gonna be picked off. Mackenzie Alexander with the pick. We were trying to go one-on-one to Torrey Smith, which is always a pretty good idea to try when you've got the one-on-one coverage, but he just got blasted as he was about to throw this. Probably didn't get as much air under it as he would have liked to lead Torrey Smith down the field, and Mackenzie Alexander makes a solid play, and Mike Zimmer is definitely psyched about that. So the Vikings get the football right back after their turnover, and oh my, big hit on Adrian Peterson. Man, I'm seeing a little bit different side of this defense already. Brandon Boykin, we talked about him as well. Now he's showing up here, making plays. We get the football back after a punt. Carlos Hyde is not going to go down. He spins out of that, and he's loose 50, 40, 36-yard line when he's marked down. Already 6 carries for 63 yards, and most of it came right there on that big breakout run. He's not going down easily, and that hopefully will get this offense jump-started. We'd love nothing more than to have a productive run game. That was very hit or miss last year as well. 3rd and 11 on this drive. Throw over the middle. There's newcomer Chris Hogan, possession receiver, doing just that. And he's going to be short, though. 4th and 2 at the 28. We're going to call on Matt Prater once again for a much longer field goal this time. The kick is up. And yes, he keeps it inside the uprights there, dealing with a little bit of wind. Is able to make his second field goal of the half. And it's now 6-0 49ers. Yes, I know, not a barn burner, but it's okay. I'm really encouraged by what we're seeing by our defense, and it's DeAndre Groves again. His second sack of the game. Hurrying up here and trying to get down the field are the Vikings. Little dump pass to Peterson, and he is stopped short of the first down. We're going to take the timeout, maybe get the football back. Well, we will get the football back, but maybe have a chance to get down the field with it, as this punt is hopefully going to go through the end zone. No, it sticks right there at about the 4-yard line. That'll make it the 3. Okay, maybe we'll just be taking a knee and go into the third quarter. That's exactly what we do. 2nd and 12 as we have the football first. There's Chris Hogan, and he's making that catch. Did we get a first down out of it? Yes, we did. First down, Niners at the 35. Already leading 6-0, but we'd like to put a touchdown on the board. 3rd and 5, and this throw is going to be caught, but it really doesn't matter. They don't get anything out of this play. It's going to be 4th and 5, and they will have to punt. Torrey Smith makes the catch for no gain. So the Vikings get the football back, and so far we've done a very good job against them, keeping them from getting anything really sustained as far as a drive, but they're starting to chip away right here. You saw DeAndre Groves in Teddy Bridgewater's face, and yes, this version of the Vikings has a healthy Teddy Bridgewater. I know that's something we haven't seen in a while, but look at this, 3rd and 1, and they cannot get it. I love how we are standing up against the run, and that's Bakari Rambo making the play. So far, the new additions to this defense have been standouts today. 3rd and 12 for our offense. This is going to be an errant throw that'll hit the turf, and we will have to punt. So it's kind of a chess match back and forth here a low-scoring game where field position means quite a bit. Adrian Peterson going to be able to pick up a first down. He's only got 36 yards on 13 carries. We're doing a good job bottling him up. But on second and 10, Bridgewater's got time, and he's going to hit his man, and that's Laquon Treadwell, another guy we haven't heard much of in real life. But as a Viking fan, I would like to see him step up like that, and it's Treadwell again. First down to the 8-yard line. It's going to be first and goal Vikings, and all of a sudden, they've got their best drive of the game going. Third and goal for Bridgewater, and he feels the heat a little bit there. Going to dump that off to Peterson, who has no prayer of scoring in the play. They're going to settle for a field goal attempt and a field goal make. So we're well into the fourth quarter, and all we've seen today is field goals out of either side. So will we see a touchdown in this one? Well, I don't know. First and 10 with about 7 minutes to play and change. There is a pass to Cecil Shorts, and once again, he will fight for first down yardage and be just short. Second and inches. Let's give it to Carlos Hyde. Yes, let's do that. See if he can break off another big run and get himself over 100 yards. Well, no, but he gets a first down, and he is at 72. Let's start working him here on this drive. That's a nice another chunk off the left-hand side. Give him 8, and it'll be second and 2. Fullback in the game now. And again, a first down. We're going to chew this clock under 5 minutes now. Carlos Hyde up to 84 yards rushing, averaging 5.6 a carry. Much higher than his average for the season last year, that's for sure. Second and 6 in the pass is to McDonald. His first catch of the game. That's going to leave him just inches short here with about 3.5 minutes to play. Carlos Hyde burrowing again for a first down. And we're down to the 2-minute warning now. 3rd and 3. A quick little pass, and it's caught. Is it McDonald again? Yes. We have a healthy Zach Miller, but McDonald making a couple more catches here. I don't think we've heard from Miller today. I don't even know if he's made a catch. So now the Vikings using their timeouts. They've got one left. 2nd and 2. Carlos Hyde. Yeah, he's close. Timeout, and it's 3rd and 1. That was their last timeout. Carlos Hyde again, and he's got the first down, and that pretty much will salt the game away, or at least it should. Now, here's where things get a little stupid on my part. I got a rookie quarterback who hasn't thrown a touchdown pass, right? So I'm thinking that'd be great if he did it. Instead, we pull a Seattle Seahawks Super Bowl move on the goal line. What are we doing passing there and giving them another chance? That's where a video game let's rack up stat kind of thing preceded what I should be doing football strategy wise, but it looks like Groves is going to bail me out again. Did they only give him half a sack there? It said 2.5 sacks. Look at that play. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, you know who bailed me out? That is Brandon Boykin. He basically volleyball sets this to himself, rights himself, finds it, and makes the catch on the rebound while staying inbounds. This is a heck of a play right there. He didn't even see the ball at first when it was thrown. He's able to kind of just knock it up in the air and then make the play. What a beautiful play. Okay, with seconds left, I'm still chasing this possible touchdown pass, and instead I gave him 3 interceptions in the game. So it was very sloppy. It was not my proudest moment at the end there. I usually play this as if this were a real-life thing going down here and how an NFL team would approach that. Obviously, they would have taken knees, and none of those last 2 interceptions would have happened. I was looking for this kid to have his moment, and instead I gave him 3 interceptions. So that's on me. I'm sorry, Carson Helfitt. We'll try to work that out as we go. I'm actually pretty impressed with what I saw with his tools here. He's got a good arm. He can make some throws, and I think as we settle him in, he will do well. Carlos Hyde goes over 100 yards, so we succeeded right there. I didn't manage to screw his day up. So we look at the receiving numbers as well. Very much spread out here. Zach Miller did make 2 catches for 14 yards, so he was in the offense a little bit. But it's very much spread out here. And then we see DeAndre Groves, 2.5 sacks in his NFL debut. 6 assisted tackles, 2 solo. The dude's a beast. Welcome to San Francisco, DeAndre Groves. We definitely made the right selection there, number 5 overall. And I think he is going to be a force to be reckoned with. And teams are going to have to game plan around him. Now we got a trade offer for Jimmy Ward, who is our backup free safety, only by a couple points. But take a look at these offers. Tell me if you would do anything with any of these five offers on the table. I know they're kind of in the future on the draft picks for the most part, at least the real good ones, but he's behind Eric Reed here by a couple points. Now, he is slightly younger. He's only had 3 years in the league where Reed's had four, but what would you do? Would you trade Reed there? Would you keep him for depth? Would you keep amassing those draft picks for down the line? Let me know what you would do in that situation with the trade offer. We'll see you next time for more San Francisco football.